Welcome to episode 12 of My Friend Simon Sorcerer. I'm your host, Lostwolfe, and we're about to go upstairs. Oddly, in Sorcerer's room, there's a Sorcerer's room, you can see a mouse going in there. It's very difficult to miss unless you're looking for it. There's a lot to do, so we're going to pick up a pouch over here. There's a sock on the floor. There's a book over here, and Sorcerer's got a lot of magic paraphernalia lying around, so the book is very good to have because the book is kind of part of his magic paraphernalia. And he also has a shiny wand, which we want from over here. And now, as with all these guys, there is a talking magic mirror. So we talk to the magic mirror. Hi, magic mirror. Murmur on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all? Well, ain't you, that's for sure. What's the matter? Never seen a talking mirror before? Simon, get a grip, will you? La-da-da, talking mirror. Nope, I haven't seen a talking mirror before. So, you're a magical talking mirror then. There we go. I'm actually a magical scrying mirror. I can see out of any reflective surface anywhere in the world. Just name the place and you can hear and see it, as if though it were right here. I don't particularly want to see anyway. You're some kind of spying device? I prefer the term surveillance. Sorcerer uses meter system in hatching evil plots. He's a sod though. Do you know how long it's been since I last had a good polish? He treats me like some sort of slave. I've got feelings, you know. Anyways, the point is we need to use the surveillance / scrying device to go and spy on these people. But we'll get there in a minute. What do you know, Max? An intruder. Intruder, yeah. I bet, like, that he's come to deal with Sorcerer. Sorcerer, yeah. Shall we, like, go and tell him? Tell him, yeah. He couldn't just sit here where the boss gets, you know, done over, yeah. Then again, we could just do our jobs and, you know, like, eat him, eat the intruder, like, where he stands. Or... I like how this has got a very long Edom, yeah, a long time between things to happen. Or we can just carry on with the game and just like ignore the intruder. Ignore, yeah. Okay then. Anyway, these two, there's a whole long conversation tacked behind them. So I'm gonna pick up everything I need to get here quickly before I talk to them because there's a fair amount of conversation to have with them. We also need a bunch of chemicals, which I don't think I picked up. No, I did not. And I'm going to use the chemicals on the shield. And look at the pair of books I got. This makes the shield a reflective surface, so since we have a scrying mirror, and now we have another mirror, we can... shield with the hook. However, a reflective mirror, we can actually watch these guys, which is something that we're going to want to do. But first, a thing I forgot to do while I was downstairs was... So, hang on. Let me just... I'll show you. It's a lot easier if I show you. There are two books. This is its sorted spell book. It looks just like mine. There's a spell to return demons to hell. You need a double square with 8 candles, a mouse, and you also need to know the true name, demon's true names. Sorry, he was going too fast there. Okay, you need a double square with 8 candles, a mouse, and a human skull. We have most of that, we're going to get the mouse now. So we're going to use the pouch with this hole here. We saw a mouse go in there, so we're going to just get him to come out and steal him for a minute. Thank you, friend. I didn't get the mouse, did I? I did not. Sometimes you have to do this multiple times before the mouse will come out. I am not getting him either of these. Oh, goodness. This is a randomized thing. Either you're going to catch the mouse or you won't. And I am not catching the mouse. That's great. Oh, maybe. Oh, no, I don't. I thought it might be further down in my inventory. This is one of those things that's sort of annoying. Okay. In my test playthrough, I got it the second time, and now, of course, the mouse is being ridiculous. I'm gonna try once more, and if I don't get it now, what I'll probably do is we'll go upstairs. I'll have the conversation with the, let's go have the conversation with the demons quickly, and I'll come back down and worry about this, because the conversation with the demons is very long. Okay. Hello. Does like two orcs eyes and a goblin tooth beat a triple dragon? I don't thought not. I lose again, Max. Again, yeah. What are you? What do we look like? Your shake, Max. So tech prevents me from passing comment. Well, you look like demons, haha. And my mommy says I mustn't talk to strangers. I've tried this one, it leads to a very long conversation. I'm gonna try and circumvent it by saying you look like demons, haha. Not bad. But what we actually are is, you know, angry, annoyed, bothered, cross, displeased, exasperated, flustered, harassed, irritable, nettled, out of humor, peeved, piqued, put out, riled, ruffled, and vexed. Ain't we, Max? Irritated, yeah. Why are we irritated? I hear you ask. And then you get that choice, right? I'm not really interested. I got enough problems. But we gotta appear to be irritated. I mean, interested. It doesn't matter. I can tell you're not interested. Not interested, yeah. Got any smokes? I don't know what you mean. It's a faulty habit, you know. You really should give up. It's not big and it's not clever, you know. I'm afraid not. It's a faulty habit. You really should give up. It's alright. We've got like loads. And wait, loads. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna go downstairs quickly and try and catch the mouse again. Because I need a mouse for what we're going to do. Oh, goodness. That's not supposed to happen. The game slightly blue screened, and let's hopefully see if it doesn't do that again. Uh oh. This is possibly gonna make the text tricky to read. Saw the mouse. Okay, alright. Let's talk to the magic mirror. Do you require my services now? Show me the lab on the top floor. There's a good chap. What is it like being a mirror? There's nothing I want from a talking mirror. This is kind of funny. On reflection, I'm really hung up about it. Ha. It was funny down at the pub. Hilarious. Anyway, show me the lab on the top floor. There's a good chap. What's the point? It's only just up the stairs. I want to spy on Gerald and Max. They're not here to ask questions. Get on with it. I have a fear of spiral staircases. Oh, goodness. I can't imagine why they'd be worth spying on, but okay, here goes. Why are you so, like, nervous in front of strangers? I can't actually pronounce the names. Wouldn't you be with a name like Multigrabbit? I think that's his name. It's not much better than Snogfunnel, really. Suppose not. Multigrabbit and Snogfunnel. I've seen enough. Thanks for your help, Mr. Murat. Okay, I'm gonna try going down and seeing if we can get rid of the visual stew, but I don't think so. It might be that the way I'm doing this has just sort of run out of memory and now we're having issues. Use this with that. I would like to be able to catch the mouse, please. No mouse. Okay. Let's head on upstairs. This is, again, a fairly long conversation. And I kind of want to get this over with. So we can move on. Okay, so let's talk to... Excuse me. Yeah? Coward demon, I'm a powerful wizard. Why do you stay here if you're dissatisfied? I thought demons were huge red monsters that breathe fire and fly. Sorry, I thought you were someone else. The obvious question is why they're dissatisfied. We don't have any, like, choice. Sworded won't let us go. What's with the sworded guy anyway? Why would he want you two around and our poor little demony weenies? Oh, goodness. He wants to, you know, rule the universe. Doesn't he? Rule, yeah. I blame the parents. Parents, yeah. And just where do you two fit into these plans? How does he intend to do that? Never fear, I, Simon, intend to stop him. Why didn't someone stop him? Okay. And just how, where do you two fit into these plans? We are sort of personal bodyguards. Jailers? Gardeners? Cleaners? Chefs? You name it, like, we do it. We do, yeah. It's a living hell. Surely you would prefer it that way. It sounds like a reasonable life to me. Why don't you have wild demon strike? We're already having one. He doesn't, like, keep us here to play dice, you know. To be honest, I'm not really sure why he keeps us here at all, ever since he got hold of that wand. Our talks have been rather limited. Limited, yeah. We read about it, he read about it in a children's book. It turns people like stone. Stone, yeah. Which accounts for those very lifelike statues of the people that tried to, like, stop him. Those statues were once people? He must have turned Calypso into one. Is there any way to restore them? Okay, I'm scared. Which way is out? I've read that book. All I need is a talking lion. I've read that book too. It's correct. Remember, kids, strikes really screw you up. If I were you, kiddo, you wouldn't see me for, like, dust. Dust, yeah. Okay, I'm scared. Show me the door. I think it could be time for a strategic withdrawal. Where's the way out? I'm having second thoughts about this whole idea. Farewell. You don't scare me. I'm on a mission from God. Sorry, but, like, the only way to get out is through the teleporter in this room. The teleporter's on the left, by the way. Personally, I'm blurred if I'm going to tell you how to use it. Oh, please, why won't you tell me? What have I ever done to you? We're demons. We don't work for the good of the people, you know. People, yeah. What do you want? Why don't you just escape using the teleporter? I can make it with you while. Be gone, demon. Tell me how to use it so I can send you back once you came. I mean, it makes sense that if they know how to use the teleports, they should probably go where they're supposed to. We tried. It doesn't, like, work for demons. We need a wizard powerful enough, like, to send us back to the pit. Pit, yeah. Look no further. I summon a sorcerer will save you. But I'm a powerful wizard. Stuff you. Why should I help a pair of low-life demons? Well, we know that they have the way to use the teleporter. I'm better off. I'd better go find one then. So I'm going to say, but I'm a powerful wizard. Pardon my lack of confidence, oh mighty one. I love that. That's a good retort. But, like, you're hardly a wizard at all. Oh yeah? I've killed for less than that. Should you care to step outside? And what makes you think I'm not a wizard, eh? Good question. I met a few wizards in my time, like... And they're all fat, chemical-stained, befuddled old fools. Fools, yeah. I'd be 15 in 2 months and 3 days. My tutor is always calling me a fool. I'm quite befuddled, I'll have you know. Ha, foolish creatures. I'm traveling in disguise. Nah, it's out of fashion to be fat and old these days. Oops. I meant to go for 2 months and 3 days. I can't be bothered to, like, argue. If you are a wizard, then send us back to the pit. And in return, we'll tell you how to, you know, work the teleport. That seems fair enough. Teleport. Yeah. Right then, I'll just go and get prepared. Okay, I'm gonna save very quickly because I don't really feel like doing all that again. I guess I better, like, pack my bags then. Bags, yeah. And I'm gonna try, and I'm gonna go find the mouse. So I'm gonna save quickly. What we're gonna do, I'm gonna go downstairs, I'm gonna try and see if I can find a mouse. If I can find a mouse, I will come back, and we will just pick up from there. And if I can't find a mouse, then we'll do that next week. Okay, so I'm going to pause very quickly, and when I come back, I will have the mouse, hopefully. Okay, so after a whole long replay, I am back here. We have all the pieces. I eventually got the mouse. I had to redo that all over again. We're going to talk to the demons. Hello again. Got it sorted then? I'll just draw a quick magic square on the floor. Here. You can borrow my chalk. Places all his candles. This is actually pretty neat here, that they do like a whole spell and everything. Okay, we're all set. Let's rock. I'm not a fan of that choice of words, but sure, I'm impressed. I'm very impressed. This might just, like, work. Work, yeah. Here, kiddo, now I'll tell you how to operate the, like, teleport. Just push the big red button marked self-destruct and sell the machine where you want to go. It's a one-way trip though. You can't just, like, get back without the password. Password, yeah. And we don't, like, know it. Demon lights the fire for us, and he steps into the, they both step in fact, take it away Sunny, both step into the little mystical portal spell thing. Okay, here goes. Sabag, Zinzan, Xenog, Yarmak. Zog. Ah! looks like we're stuck in. And then everything goes wavy and they disappear. Wow. That really tingled. Oh, but worked okay. Okay, so we're gonna head over to the teleport. This is where we're gonna end. I'm gonna get into a teleport and we're gonna go to where we're supposed to head. This is quite cute too. This is Sparky, the talking teleporter, at your service. It would be my pleasure to whisk you safely and conveniently to the destination of your choice. I've forgotten where I want to go. The fiery pits of Rondor, please. Your selected destination is, please fasten seatbelts and extinguish smoking materials. And then off we go, and we're at the fiery pits of Rondor. This is where I'm going to end. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been episode 12 of my friend Simon the Sorcerer. I shall see you all on Wednesday, hopefully when we finish the game. I thought we were going to finish the game today, but then I looked at what we had to do, and like I said, there's a fair bit at the end to do, so there you go. Thank you so much for watching, and as I say, see you in a couple of days' time. Have a great 2 days, folks. Bye-bye.